Hello, and welcome to the first of a series of conversations on energy literacy. My name is LEROY Ferguson, and I work in the Office of Public Housing, and I represent over 3,100 public housing authorities, 1.2 million public housing residents. On my staff here, on my panel, I have Josh from the Department of Energy.
Hello.
Jamie from the Department of Energy.
Hello.
And Heidi from the Department of Education.
Hello.
So, Josh, why would energy literacy be important to our public housing residents?
That's a great question. So energy literacy is the understanding of, essentially, this guy right here. Where does our energy come from? And every time we turn the light on and turn the light off, where's all that electricity coming from? And when we understand it a little better, when we ask questions about energy, we have the ability to affect our pocket and also our communities and the environment in those communities. So it's important.
So you're saying I can actually save money if I turn the lights off?
Oh, absolutely. Oh. Absolutely. And let me explain a couple ways you can do that. So when your light's on, clearly you're getting electricity from fossil fuels. But what I do in my house is I use a power strip. And the reason why is this. Do you have a television with a little red light in the corner when you turn it off?
Yes, I do.
That little red light requires energy. So even when you're turning things off at your house, you are actually still spending money on energies. A lot of us leave our cell phones plugged in at night as we're charging them when we sleep. We don't need to charge our phones for 8 hours. So what I do is I plug my television and my cell phone charger and other things into a power strip. And when I turn the power strip off, all that energy that I, while I was sleeping and didn't need to use, I'm no longer using. So I'm saving money and I'm using less electricity.
So you're saying that we can all do a better job of saving energy.
Yeah, and saving energy is really important in today's environment. Because when we turn our lights off, what we're really doing is burning less fossil fuels.
Fossil fuels? What exactly is fossil fuels?
Wow. So in the United States, we use three major types of fossil fuels. We use petroleum, we use natural gas, and we use coal to power our lives. We use the petroleum in our cars and the natural gas and coal for the electricity in our homes. Those fossil fuels, when we burn them, release something called carbon dioxide and other gases. But carbon dioxide, we know, causes greenhouse effect and global warming. So by turning off my light, what I'm doing is using less fossil fuels, which means I'm releasing less carbon into the air, which means I'm having a positive impact on this climate debate or climate change.
So it's better for the environment.
Better for the environment, better for my pocket, and really it's important that you know that there's actually alternatives to fossil fuels as well. It's so exciting to work at the Department of Energy where we have we do research on solar, on wind, on water energy, on energy from biomass and energy from algae, energy from waste, energy from the tides going up and down, energy from the wades coming in and out. We can get energy under in a river just from the current of the river. We can get energy from many what's called renewable sources that don't release carbon dioxide. And it's really exciting because it's a time in America where there's a lot of change going on in energy and lots of new opportunities.
So this new energy, renewable energy you refer to, is it cleaner and more abundant?
Absolutely. So I like to think about clean energy. Where did the energy from this apple come from?
The sun?
The sun, right? And so sun is renewable energy, and it's abundant. We have it every day. Interesting fact, LEROY, the sun, enough sunlight hits the earth in one day to power all of our lives on the entire planet for a whole year. We don't capture all of it, of course. But yeah, renewable energy is cleaner and extremely abundant. I just want to add one more thing. When you work out, right? When you, I like to work out, you work out?
Yes, sir, I do.
Where's that energy coming from?
The food I eat.
The food we eat, right? And so we are what we eat. And really, we're tapping into the energy of the sun every time we take a bite out of anything.
So Jamie, what else is the Department of Energy doing towards energy literacy?
Of course, I'll tell you about our new initiative that Secretary Ernest Moniz had launched in 2013. It's guided under my director, Dot Harris. It's called the Minorities in Energy Initiative. What it is, we're trying to help minority communities be more involved in the energy sector. And the three pillars that we're focusing on is STEM education, workforce development, energy economic development, and climate change. We also have ambassadors that are helping us with this initiative. We have honorary ambassadors as well as Department of Energy champions. If you want more information, please visit our website at www.energy.gov-minoritiesinenergy.
This sounds very interesting. Would this be able to impact some of the public housing residents we serve?
Of course it will, because we're trying to get more to get the minority community to understand the importance of STEM education, energy, economic development, and climate change. As you know, minorities are not geared in those three areas, so we're trying to make sure that they are more knowledgeable and more advanced in these areas as we go on in the workforce.
So more education?
Yes.
So, Heidi, how would the Department of Education help towards STEM?
Great. Well, we're very interested in STEM, and we're very involved in STEM activities. We know that there's a large gap in the amount of jobs that are available in STEM opportunities and the amount of people who are applying. So we're interested in closing that gap, helping people connect with career pathways in STEM education. I don't think we've said what STEM is. Let's say it. STEM is science, technology, engineering, and math. Mm. So quite a wide range of jobs are available in STEM. And there are a lot that are early on the pathway, so entry-level jobs. Jobs that require a community college AA degree or a certificate program. We're very interested in connecting youth and adults with career pathways in their communities where they can get those kinds of starts in the energy or the STEM field. You can find out more at the American Job Center online or do a little research at a website called My Next Move. Lots to learn about what's going on in your community and getting connected with career pathways.
So do you have partnerships with public housing authorities?
Well, we are excited to be partnering with public housing authorities. Number one, public housing authorities are eligible providers of adult education, and they have been for many years. So we look forward to doing more with local public housing authorities, but we're excited to be here at the HUD studio, kicking off this webinar series for public housing residents and coordinators, and looking forward to doing more with your residents.
So Josh, this sounds like a tremendous opportunity for public housing residents.
It really is, and that's why we're excited to have a webinar series with all 3,100 PHAs, and we'll have our first one soon. But then also we hope to engage the public housing authority to help us craft what are our future webinars and what type of information do they really crave and what type of information can we give them. So it's exciting to be here at HUD in anticipation of our webinar series.
That is an exciting opportunity for our public housing authorities to be able to conserve energy, reduce costs, and take care of the environment.
Yeah, while also learning about amazing jobs in the energy and STEM fields.
And jobs as well. Excellent. Thank you for watching the first of an exciting series on energy conservation with a focus on energy reduction, protecting the environment, and saving money. And remember,